After 5 weeks of strict measures, New Zealand's largest city, Auckland, shifts to the looser level 3 lockdown. Cafes and restaurants have reopened for takeaway services, and construction workers have returned to work. The city will stay under this level for 2 weeks. The rest of the country is at alert level 2. New Zealand's government says vaccinations will now replace lockdowns as the main tool against the virus. Over 71% of New Zealand's eligible population have had their first dose, while 37% are fully vaccinated. The U.S. pledges to buy 500 million more COVID-19 vaccine doses to donate to other countries as it comes under increasing pressure to share its supplies with the rest of the world. Deliveries for this new tranche of donations will begin next year.
And it brings our total commitment of donated vaccines to over 1.1 billion vaccines to be donated. Put another way, for every one shot we've administered to date in America, we have now committed to do 3 shots to the rest of the world. Nothing is more urgent than all of us working together to defeat COVID-19.
Japan is also doubling its COVID-19 vaccine donation to 60 million doses. It has already provided about 23 million doses, mostly to Asian nations like Taiwan, Vietnam, and Indonesia. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration authorizes a third dose of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine for those aged 65 and above. The FDA will also amend Pfizer's emergency use authorization to allow booster shots for high-risk Americans. These include health workers and employees who are constantly exposed to the virus. The agency says booster doses should be administered at least 6 months after the completion of the second jab. The Philippines drops its face shield mandate in outdoor areas. President Rodrigo Duterte approved the new policy upon the recommendation of medical experts. But face shields will still be required in indoors and crowded areas.
I was informed that the technical advisory group and the medical experts on the use of face shields pwede na tanggalin sa labas. No more face shields outside. Ang limitasyon, ang face shields gamitin mo, 3 C's. S with S, 3 C's. Close whatever facility, hospital, o basta magkadikit-dikit. Crowded, ganun rin. It's a crowded room, tapos close lahat, mas delikado, at saka ang close contact kung magkadikit-dikit ang tao. So dyan applicable pa rin ang face shield.
Back in June, Duterte said face shields should only be for hospital use. But he quickly retracted his statement after the Delta COVID-19 variant was detected in the country. Government will soon release new guidelines on its face shield policy to avoid confusion.
I-define natin yung mga lugar na considered crowded. So, halimbawa, ang palengke. Ang palengke ay may mga palengking open area pero considered crowded. So, i-define po natin itong mga crowded areas. Gaya, in others, we will be very specific kung ano itong mga crowded areas na i-define natin.
Face shields have been a point of debate due to doubts over its effectiveness. The Philippines is the only country that mandated its use. Malacañang warns the public against complacency as the country adopts a more relaxed face shield mandate. It says the move does not mean the more transmissible Delta variant is now less risky. Malacañang adds government is continuously improving the country's healthcare system to prepare for possible future surges.
Ang problema po kasi nagkakasakit yung ating mga frontliners na nagiging dahilan naman para sa mga ilang mga malalaking pribadong hospital na huwag nang tumanggap ng karagdagang mga COVID patients. Ipadadala na nga po natin yung ating AFP Medical Corps to augment yung manpower requirements sa mga ospital kung saan maraming mga nagkasakit na health workers. Nagkakaroon din po tayo ng malawakang pagre-recruit ng mga health professionals gaya nung nangyari nung nauna ng surge.